Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Skillset Guru. In the previous video, we have seen how to create a simple Spring Boot project in Eclipse. So in this video, we will create a fresh project with a web project. So in previous video, we have not created a web project. In this video, we will create a simple Spring Boot web project. So let's right click, new project, type Spring. Click on Spring Starter Project. So here we have got a default values, default project name, type, version, group, artifact. So name, we have already demo project, that's why it's giving demo one. So let's rename it to Spring Web. And let's leave all these values here. Click on next. So previously we have not selected any dependencies from this list, so that's why it was a simple Spring Boot project. Now we want a web project, so we need to search web dependency here, and now we will get here a Spring Web. Let's click on Spring Web. We want this dependency. So let's click next and finish. Here you can observe import getting started content. So this project will create little more faster than the first project, because during the first project all the jars needs to be downloaded from the internet. For the next project, it will use already downloaded jars from the laptop. If it wants any extra jars, it will download from the internet. So if you expand this progress, you can see import getting started content. So let's wait for this process. Okay, the project is successfully created and the progress is completed. So let's expand our project structure and let's see. So let's close these files from the previous project, that is demo project. So here if you observe, we have the same structure, Java resources, test, and 1.8 version of Java Maven dependencies. If we expand a Maven dependencies, as this is the web project, we have included a web dependency, we will get all the jars required for the Spring Boot web project. If we see, we have a Jackson jars, a Spring Web MVC. If we observe, we will have a embedded Tomcat dependency also here. So let's search for Tomcat dependency. Spring Web embedded WebSocket Spring Boot starter Tomcat. If you see, we have a Spring Boot starter Tomcat jar. This is a embedded Tomcat. If you open a simple Spring project and open Maven project, Maven dependencies, here we are not having a Tomcat dependency because we have created this project as a simple project, not a web project. So if you observe, we don't have many dependent jars here, because as this is not a web project, it doesn't require all the dependencies. But here we have a more dependencies as this is a web project. If we open a POM file of this, we will be having Spring Boot starter web, but the previous project has just Spring Boot starter, it doesn't have a web. So this is a simple difference between a web project and the normal Spring Boot project. So here we are getting an error. If we update this project, it will be fine. Update project. Let's click on force update and OK. So the Maven project is getting updated. Now we have created a Spring Web project successfully. As soon as we update a Maven project, that error in POM XML file also gone. So as this is a web project, we need to have a HTML page or JSP pages. So by default, a Spring looks all the pages into a web app folder. So the web app folder should be in source, main, and inside main there needs to be a web app folder. So let's create a web app folder. New folder. Let's name it web app. Finish. So the Spring project looks all the JSP pages or HTML pages into this folder. So for our demo purpose, let's create a simple HTML page and let's try to access it. New HTML page. So let's name it hello. Finish. So now we have created hello.html page. So let's write anything in body. Welcome to Spring Web Project. So we will try to access this HTML page from the browser after running this web app. So how to start this project? Run as a Spring Boot application. So the normal Spring Boot project also we have run using Spring Boot application. This also we will run Spring Boot application. So web server failed to start. Port 8080 was already in use. So I have already started the Tomcat. Let's close all the projects and let's try to run it again. So if you observe, the Spring web project starts a Tomcat automatically. So starting service Tomcat on port 8080. So we can access this HTML page directly from the web browser. Let's open a browser. Type localhost, as this is running in the laptop. Port is 8080 slash. We can access any resource in a web app. So we have created hello.html. So we have wrote welcome to Spring web project in a body. So we are getting this page. So we have successfully run this Spring Boot web project and accessed an HTML page. So this is a simple Spring Boot web application. So the main use case of this web application is not accessing the resources. It is mainly for the REST APIs. It is mainly used for the REST APIs. We will see all those concepts in the next videos. I hope you liked this video and understood. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.